Welcome back to the Mozilla Festival. We're here with Simon Close, filmmaker. He's going to talk to us about LinkLib and his project about Pirate Bay. So first, what is this documentary we hear about Pirate Bay?
The Pirate Bay Away from Keyboard is a film about the personal process of the founders of the world's largest file sharing site, the Pirate Bay. I've been filming them for around 4 years and I've been following the court case very close in Sweden.
So it's been a lot of footage from what we could gather last year, like 200 hours or something like that. Yes. So how do you get to edit all this in a shorter way?
Well, that's always a problem for filmmakers, you know. You have to make your creative choices, you know. You can't use all the scenes that you have, you know, even though some of them might be very powerful. In my case, with the Pirate Bay film, I had both a very journalistic side, you know, where I interviewed people about the consequences of the open internet and file sharing and so forth. And then I've also shot the film in a style that's very much more observational, a character-driven documentary. And that side is much more appealing to me. So when I met this amazing editor, Per K. Kierkegaard, in Denmark, who actually edited the film, he threw out all the journalistic crap and made a observational documentary thriller out of my footage.
So when is it available to watch? When will it be finished?
So that's up to the film festivals. We don't really know yet. We've just applied to a bunch of film festivals. We hope to be able to release it early 2013. So it's very close now. We're almost there after 5 years.
All right. And to switch to the editing aspect of things, we just hosted a session about linklib.org, which is a library where you can add layers above a video. Could you maybe describe the project for us?
Exactly. Well, I have this problem, you know. As a filmmaker, I want to embed links into my films. I want to give people more stories, you know, and I want to give them like the extra material or the deleted scenes of my film or the crazy large piracy debate on the internet. I would love to find a way to embed that into the films. So in my sort of search for a way to do that, I found this amazing technology called Popcorn.js, developed by this internet-loving company called Mozilla. And when I found this technology, I was really struck by the power to sort of deepen stories. But it was also kind of distracting for me, because it kind of looked like, you know, YouTube's annotations. It was pop-ups, you know. And being a filmmaker and a photographer as well, I've shot most of my film myself, I spend a lot of time on composition, on lenses, on color grading. I don't want annoying pop-ups in my frame. So we built a system where we can actually send time sync links from films to the audience's phones, the audience's tablets, the audience's second screens. So this way, the audience can actually check their films in full screen, like they always do, and choose for themselves if they want to watch this information while they're seeing the film or after the film.
So as a tool for filmmakers and also tools for just a normal internet user who can actually recreate an experience. Do you have any examples on your site, famous ones you can quote maybe?
Yeah, well sure. This system at the moment only works for YouTube and Vimeo. It's for streamed video, and on YouTube, there are lots of different types of videos. It could be feature films. It could be, I mean, trailers at least. They could be feature films, documentaries. They could be memes, I mean, user-generated videos or music videos. So some examples of what you could do with our system is that you could take the Mitt Romney and Obama presidential debates, and maybe you could just focus on the clip about Big Bird, where Mitt Romney says that he would cut funding for PBS, for instance. That became a meme on YouTube. So what I've done there is I've just taken the debate and I've added all the links to all the comedy shows, like you know, Stephen Colbert or like James or Jon Stewart, The Daily Show, and Kermit remixes, and a bunch of different information within the actual political debate. So it becomes a tool for political analysis, it becomes a tool for comedy, it becomes a tool for commerce, it becomes a tool for debate.
And still talking about storytelling tools, so we have Popcorn.js, now yes. Popcorn Maker. We have also Ziga, which is very, very trendy right now, yes, because it's just arrived. Yes. Have you had the chance to either try the beta version or to talk to one of the creator?
Yes, I love Ziga, and James Burns is a friend of mine. But I haven't really gotten into it because I've been obsessed by by the deadline for my own project. And so I haven't really checked it out, but it looks very, very interesting.
Can you give us a website for people to get more information about your project?
Linklib.org. And at the moment, we will be releasing the system with invites only. But just drop us a mail and we'll send you an invite. Everybody's welcome.
Thank you so much for talking to us. So you can visit linklib.org and already have a taste of what is it about. Thank you for watching. This was Marco Vision on TV.